Hello everyone, welcome to JCL series part 3. In this video, we are going to look into the EXEC statement, job lim and step lim statements in detail. Before getting into this video, those who haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. So EXEC statement. So before EXEC statement, in the previous video, we have discussed about job statement. So job statement indicates the operating system that a job is going to be processed. So the next statement after job statement is EXEC statement. So EXEC statement, as its name indicates, execute a program or execute a proc. That is the function of EXEC statement. So a job step. So EXEC statement will be present in a step. So the job step is a unit of work submitted to the OS in the form of JCL statements. So it is just a unit of work submitted to the operating system. So EXEC statement is the first statement of each job step. So after the job statement, the next statement will be EXEC statement. So within a job, a maximum of 255 EXEC statements can be coded. So below is an example of job with EXEC statements. Here the first two lines are job statement, or it can also be called as job card. And after that is step 01 EXEC PGM equal to report gen, and step 2 EXEC PGM equal to report backup. So these two are EXEC statements. Step 1 is report generating program, and step 2 is a report backup program. After the report generation statement is report generation program is executed, the same report is backed up using this step. So that we have seen and taken it as an example for that. So EXEC statement comprises of the following parts in it. Two slashes. As usual, it comprises of two slashes, then step name, then the EXEC operation part, and PGM equal to program name. So in the PGM only we will be mentioning the name of the program to be executed. Then keyword parameters. So PGM is a positional parameter, and followed by that is the keyword parameters. So let's begin with the step name. Step name is of 8 characters in length. It cannot exceed 8 characters, and it can comprise of A to Z, 0 to 9, and the national characters hash, at, and dollar. It can comprise of anything, but it cannot begin with a numeric. It can be alphanumeric, but the step name cannot begin with a numeric in it. It can begin with a national character as well as alphabet, and it can be a combination of these three things: alphabet, number, and national characters. So next, followed by the so EXEC PGM equal to program name. So PGM is a positional parameter in the EXEC statement. So PGM identifies the name of the program that is to be executed. Whatever given in PGM equal to program name, that program or that proc will get executed. So where the program will be present? So the program will be present in system libraries or private libraries. So system libraries, in the sense, if we are going to execute utilities, like there are many utilities in the IBM predefined library, IBM system library, like the utilities like IEB copy, IEB gener, then IEB edit, IEH list. These are utilities which are already written and stored in the system library. So if you want to execute those utilities, so that utilities will be called from the system libraries. So private libraries are user defined libraries. So we will be writing a program in COBOL or PROC in JCL, and we will put that PROC in our own libraries. That is called as private library. So it must be a PDS. So whatever program that we are going to run must be a member of a PDS. So the next Next parameter which we are going to see is account parameter, which is a keyword parameter. In the job statement also we have seen one account parameter which is used for billing purpose of the job. In this EXEC statement, account parameters there. So account equal to accounting information comma accounting information, which is an additional accounting information. Here also accounting information, as its name indicates, it is used for billing purpose only. So this is the syntax. Within braces they will be giving accounting information comma accounting information, or if it is only one information, we can directly give it as ACCT equal to account information. So the rules are maximum of 142 characters only we can specify the account information. And if there are any special characters inside this accounting information, we should use an apostrophe for mentioning it. So here is an example for accounting information. Step 1, EXEC, PGM equal to program and account. So this step alone can be built using this. That is the CPU billing can be done for this step alone. So for that only the accounting information is specified here. So it is having two accounting information here. Here is an example with only one accounting information. So next parameter is PALM parameter. So PALM parameter is a keyword parameter. It is used to supply information to a program in execution. So whenever we are executing a program, if we want to pass some value to the program which is executing, we can use the PALM parameter. So PALM equal to value. So in this example you can see step 1 EXEC, PGM equal to PALM sub. So it is a sample program for subtraction which I have written, and PALM equal to 20, 10. I have given two values. I am going to pass this 20 and 10 to the program PALM sub. So this value will be received in the linkage section of the program. So now let us see the program in execution. I'm connecting to the mainframe system. So first I am going to show you the program. So this is the PALM sub. PALM sub indicates that I have used PALM for doing subtraction. So I have given name like that. So I am going to do a subtraction here. So you can see here, this is a COBOL program with the program ID. This is the program name, data division, working storage section, and the difference of AB. The difference of AB I have declared as a 3-digit number, and PALM field. So this is the, for PALM field we have to specify the length also, a length, and as well as we should declare it as comp. So PALM length I have given as signed 9 of 5. It can accommodate 5 digits, signed 9 of 5. So this is the field, PALM field. So this is the name of the field in which the value will be passed from the JCL. Whatever passed in the JCL will be received by this PALM field, and again it will pass to the PALM value here. PALM value here, PALM A value 9 of 2, PALM B value 9 of 2. So it can accommodate 2 digit, and it can accommodate 2 digits in it. And procedure division, so here only we'll mention what all needs to be executed. So PALM field, so procedure division using PALM field. So I have given PALM field here in linkage section. I have named the field as PALM field. The same name I am using in procedure division. Procedure division using PALM field, which is given in the linkage section. I have already declared this PALM variables in linkage section, and that value I am using here in procedure division. So the values will be passed to this field, and it will in turn pass to PALM A value and PALM B value. So here compute statement will do the mathematical operations, computation operations. Difference of AB, difference of AB equal to palm A val. So whatever stored in palm A val and whatever stored in palm B val will get subtracted and it will be stored in diff AB. Display diff AB will return the difference amount in the output statement. So I have compiled it already. I have compiled it already, and I have placed the object in that particular load library in matekn.lib. The object is already present. Now I am going to run this program. I am just going to run this program. So here you can see in step 1 exec. So this is the exec statement, and here pgm equal to palm sub. So whatever program which we need to execute, that we have to specify here. Palm sub is the program which we saw minute back, and palm equal to 20, 10. So this value will be passed to this palm sub, which will be executed now. So this 20, 10 will go to palm field in the palm sub program. So now let's run this program. You can see max CC as 0. Here the job name is matekn and job ID is 1012. So matekn only one job is present. So 1012 our job only. Put question mark and insist out. You should see the difference of 20 and 10 we have passed. So the difference of two numbers using palm values is 10. So this is how the palm statement works. So palm parameter, I think it is very clear to you. So next is job lib and step lib statement. So job lib statement follows the job statement. So as its name indicates, job library. Job lib stands for job library. So the where the job is present, the JCL of the job where it is present. So that is the that is what the job lib indicates. The job lib statement where the program specified by the exec statement resides. So exec statement will be having a program. That program will be present inside this particular job library. So job library statement must precede exec statement. So before writing, even before writing the exec statement, we will code the job library. So the job library is nothing but a PDS in which the programs will be written and stored, and that will be again whenever the exec executing a program, it will call the program from this particular library, job library, and it will execute it. And similarly, step library and job library are is one and the same, except only one difference. In step library, the step library is coded for each and every step. If the step library is coded for a particular step, that library will be referred by that step, and the program will be referred from that particular step. So here is an example for job lib and step lib. So here first job is one program, first COBOL program. I have given two steps here. So this is the job statement and this is the job library. Here step 1 exec pgm equal to first job, then step 2 equal to exec pgm equal to sub program, subtract program. So steps for step 1, above that job library is specified. So whenever this program is executed, whenever the program is executed, this first job will be referred here, matekn.loadlib. It will be referred here and it will be picked from that library and it will get executed. Whereas in step 2, the subtract program will be referred here in this step library. It will not be referred in this job library, because we have coded a step lib below the job step. So step over its job. Whenever both job leaf and step leaves are present in a program, and for that particular step, if there is a step leaf, it will refer the step leaf only. It will not refer the job leaf. For this step 01, it is not having a step library, so it will refer the job library. Whereas in the case of step 02, it is having a step library, so it will not refer the job library. Step 02 will refer only the step library. So when both job lib and step lib are present in a JCL, step lib will override the job lib for that particular step. So this subtract program, will refer this made kn.mf.e.step library. So let's execute this program also. So this is the program. First cob is one program, and sub PGM is another program. Now I am going to show this library to you. So load lib will always have object code in it. So it is having first cob in it. So this made kn.loadlib is having first cob in it, and sub PGM, let's check whether sub PGM is there or not. Subtract PGM is not there in this load library. And here sub PGM, let's check whether sub PGM is present in this particular step library. Sub PGM is only present here. So now I am going to run this job. So for separate PGM, we are passing values through systemd star. So these are two exec statements. This first cob will be referred from this load library, and this sub PGM will be referred from this step library. So if any of the load modules are not there in the load library or in the step library, so the job will append. Now let's see whether it executes fine or not. If we are getting max CC0, so we got max CC0, it indicates that the job executed fine. So now let's see the output also. Let's see the output in the spool area. Yes, ST. So this is the job which ran now. Sysout, see, it has printed two sysouts here, step 1 and step 2. Step 1, it printed a first COBOL program, and mainframe daddy the mainframe academy. Whereas it is a subtract program. In step 2 we have written a given a subtract program, the reference of two numbers is printed here. So this is how the job lib and step lib works. So once again I'm going there. So first cob is referred in this library, and sub PGM is referred in this step library. So this is how job lib and step lib functions in a COBOL program as well as this is how the job lib and step lib functions in a JCL. So these are the parameters which we have discussed so far: job lib, step lib, PGM. step name, accounting information parameter and PAM parameter. So in the next video we are going to look into the statement, condition statement, region and time. So these parameters, condition, region and time parameter, can be used in both job and exec statement. So we are going to look much more elaborately in the next video. And those who haven't subscribed my channel, kindly subscribe. And those who haven't liked it yet, please give a thumbs up. So it will motivate me. Please share it if you like it very much. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you.